a registered nurse speaking from the driver's seat of a semi-trailer.
I was stood down as of November 1st, 21.
Rebecca Crack worked at both the Logan and Children's Hospitals. Last year, her employment was terminated.
Looking into IVF, and there had been no testing on women with getting their COVID vaccine.
She was given a new position at Bow Desert Hospital in December, but it was taken away.
HR with Metro South had presumed that I wasn't honest and upfront.
Leaked emails reveal another nurse who reapplied was questioned over her termination. She replied to confirm it. The health service followed up saying they'd been given a directive to not progress her application. Another nurse received a similar email last month saying she couldn't be reemployed.
I want to be very clear that there is absolutely no barrier or directive.
If there's no directive, why are people still being terminated this week?
And it's not isolated. 7 News understands, as well as Metro South, nurses have been barred in the Darling Downs from returning to work, and another from Metro North.
Why would they be sent in the first place if the direction was clear, like you're saying?
You've been with me since we repealed these mandates. I stood up with the Director General. I've stood up many times and been very clear that there is no barrier.
It has been exposed today that she was lying.
1,249 Queensland health staff were sacked for not complying with the vaccine mandate. Since it was repealed in September, 37 of those people have been re-employed.
Everyone else is going back to work and getting off their lives. Why not health?
Anna McGraw, 7 News.